All right, we're on page 59, step number one. We need 4 times the toothpicks cut to a about 10 millimeter length. So we use our helping tool just to get it. So actually right next to my foot, so we're good to go. And all of them are trying to jump away, so just make sure you see where it's flying so you can either find it. To make sure that nobody steps on it or anything. And let's see, we need half toothpicks. Oh, never mind. I did it completely wrong. Scratch that. So on page 59, step number one, we need 4 toothpicks that are cut to specific length, which is minus 10 millimeters. So it's not a 10 millimeter pieces, but toothpicks cut slightly shorter, and considering they're about 65 millimeters, so we're looking for the length of about 55. And we need 4 of those. Alrighty. Now parts number 93, 95, 93, 94, let's start from the other end. 92, 93, 94, 93, and 95. We're all on board number 8. And right at the center cluster here. So we're looking 392. Looks like, oh, there's gonna be one mirror. So 392. 393, 394, 393 again, and 395. We need 2 toothpicks. We start with 392 with the drawing facing the side you insert the toothpicks through. Against the table, then 393 as I keep in it with the little hole facing to the left. The little tab is on the side of the hole and facing me. Then 94, just make sure the shape is outline is the same, so the longer side is without the holes is on the left. Then another 93 with the tab on the same side. And then 95. To close it all up, we cut the center toothpick, not the top one. Top one we keep. And then we need 6 396s. And there's 2 clusters of them. I'm going to take 1, push all these out, because they're small, I'll use the helping tool, and then clean them up with my fingers. The excess wood pieces that are stacked to them, and all of those are go onto the toothpick all the way against the sub assembly. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then we we cut off the toothpick. And now we need to make a mirror of that image as shown on the portion right here. So we need 93, we got 92, 93. There was a 406 that fell out. And I put them aside just to make sure I don't lose them. 94, 93 again. And 95. I'm gonna take the cluster of 396 because I know I'm gonna need them. And let's see, so same thing with the toothpicks from the side where the marking is at. Just broke the toothpick, but I think it's okay because it's the center one, and we just need to cover a few pieces on that one, so we'll see if it's gonna have enough. All right, so now here we have it facing towards me. Now we're gonna face it away from me in order to get the mirror side of what we get. So it was 393, 394. 393 again. And 395. And I had enough length of the toothpick, so I can just snap it off. And now we need 396. On the toothpick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Cut off the excess toothpick. Excuse me. And now we have the mirror of the other one. Now we need part number 397, which is also on that board, just a little bit below to the right of the cluster. And then 397 with the mark. So let's see, with the mark on one, the tabs that are facing and to the left. Mark should be on the top. And the other tab facing towards the same direction. And then on the opposite one, the mark should be once again closer to that sub-assembly with the tab facing the other direction. I mean, the same direction as the tabs. Like that, and now turn the car upside down. You go in the back, and they go right inside there. So these are little exhaust pipes. I'm gonna put a little bit of wax on these little tabs. Those holes. There's three holes on the inside surface there. And we're done with step number 6 on page number 59. Moving on to the page number 60. Put the car aside. Now we need step 1. We need port number 398. That's on board number 6. Let's see, 398 bottom right. $399 and $400, two of them each. They're right here on the bottom left. So $399 and $400. Then we need four little toothpick cut to size 2Z. Just gonna use the new one. And then that goes onto the 300 little holes on one side. Goes let's see which way. You just want to match the shape so when they're attached together it's nice and smooth. And then that one goes on the left side. Other side, the holes are down. Insert it from the right side. And then 400. Once again, just to match. Outline. Like this. All right, and now that and step number 2, it gets inserted into the back of the car. There's two little openings there, so one on the left and one on the right. And it should fit right in. Snaps all the way to the end, so now that's our back. And now we need part number 401, which is on the top right of board number 6. And the board number 6 is empty, so we can discard it. And that goes, that's a windshield. So with the little marking, it should be going towards inside the cabin. And get those all the way in. So now we got our windshield with the wipers. And done with step number 3 on page number 60. Moving on to page number 61, we need 3 2Zs and 1 3Z. And then 1 3 toothpicks cut to 55 millimeters length, meaning we cut off 10 millimeters of one side. Part number 402, which is on board 8. 402 is the bottom right here, two of them. Just gonna do one for now. And that's not 402. Doesn't look like it is a 402. Kinda looks the same, but it's missing the top portion here. Let me check into it. Does show it its bottom one. Oh, there's part 403 on the top. So it's 402 and 403, and I was missing the 403. 403 is going to be just need to find one. I see 405, I see 404. 402, we just need one. And 403 is right in the middle to the center line, to the right a little bit, almost at the top. So 403, get it out. Now 403 and 402. And now we insert 2Z, 2 2Zs and 403. For that. Just make sure you insert it from correct side. Should be match up the lines, and now 3Z and the top hole right here, and then and 2Z on the second hole from the top. There's diagonal. I'm going to push them down to the surface. And now one of the toothpicks that we cut goes into the... Two toothpicks go into the other two holes. Now we need parts number 405 and 408. 405 is at the top. They're right next to each other. It's 2 and 3. And then 404 is right here, center, a little above middle to the right of the center line. So number 2 first, 405. That one goes to the top hole with that little opening towards the back. Two holes. And there, the third one. And a 402 with a little toothpick sticking out, and then number 3 or 408 goes onto the toothpick that is sticking out. Now 404 with number 2 on it goes on the other two long toothpicks with the two top holes. No, just one toothpick. And then the one that is closer to you, and then one shorter one. So you feed it all the way down. Turn it around. Make sure the toothpicks are flush with the surface. This one's moving. And now part number 407, and 407 is at the top. The one that is with the mark facing towards the back of the seat, we inserted onto the, we use one more toothpick, put it into the hole that is right here on the 404, and then with the mark towards the back, we insert the little 407 piece onto that two toothpicks that are there. Now we need part number 406, which I already had accidentally fall out, and we put it into the two holes that are on part number 404. Now we need 456, which is on the top right, and then 407, then 456 again. And then 407 again. Inserted onto those two toothpicks. So 407 with the marks facing towards the back. No, 456, sorry, 407. Need to go around that little tab there. Now 456 again. Sits against the tab, and now 407. With the mark facing once again on all of them towards the back. Now we need part number 410 through 414. So we need 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. That is it. Complicated seat. And now part number 409 also. 409 with one fell out, mark one. All right, and that goes from the back of the seat with the little openings down towards the bottom. Put it there. And now we need, let's see, starting with four. Facing the same outline. Four. Six. Seven. And number eight. We got the back of the seat, which is moving on its axis. We're done with page number 61. We're moving on to the page number 62. Now we need three Z's. I can use some of the toothpicks that I have here. Two 55 millimeter toothpicks. So just slice off 10 millimeters. And my table top is also marked, so I can just slice it off like that, because it's marked in 10 millimeter squares. And the two Z's go in the top two holes of that last part that we just inserted. I believe it was 414. Now the long toothpick goes in the bottom hole. And we need part number 416, which is let's see, where's 416? I see 414, 415. Four 16 is right here, right next to 404. That one goes, there's another toothpick that goes towards the smaller, thinner end into that hole on the right hand side. And then this one, we go through the all three toothpicks. Two toothpicks that are right here, and then onto the two tabs that are sticking out from part number 406, or was it 420? 406. Just like that, squeeze it hard. Now we need 415 and 417. So 415 is right here, part number 6 or 9, whichever it was. And 417 is going to be right here, right below the 416. 415 goes on the back with this slope or the number facing towards inside, so that's that way you get the right direction. Broke a little toothpick, so I'm gonna take the pliers I always have handy, make another length that I broke, which was 2Z. And insert it back in the spot. Moving on to part number 417. So that one goes through that hole. Oh, we need to cut off one of the toothpicks, the bottom ones. Pre-cut and snap it off. Clean it up a little bit. Now that's 417, so the goes through the tab hole, and then this one goes into the bottom hole. Oops. Out of two. It should fit into the all the holes, and now we need another 55 millimeter, 50 millimeter, 55 millimeter, 50 millimeter, whatever the length is. Oh, I cut off too much. Into the hole. Oh, so I need to slice that one off. And now insert, make sure it's a clean cut, and now insert the long toothpick that we just did. Now we need part number 418, which is on top of board number 8. It says number 10 in there. So that one, now we got three toothpicks. That little tab and the back facing back. We got the toothpicks through one, through the tab here, through the little tab, and then the one that is sticking out in the back, it goes in the bottom hole. To the seat. Make sure everything, all the toothpicks are still sticking out. We're done with the page number 62. Moving on to the page number 63. So I guess I can put this aside for now. That toothpick, so I'm gonna make another one and put it back in, and that one also broken. Perfect. I should probably stop for today. All right, we need 3Zs, 2Z. 1 3Z, two 55 millimeter or 50 millimeter ones, three, sorry. essentially, I believe we're gonna be making the same. That one's tough. Another seat. Now we need part number 402, I'm still having sitting around there. And 403. Gonna be at the top, about 404 there. So two Z's gonna go into the 403. The two holes. Tool to push them down all the way to the surface. And then 419, get the first hole. Is the long toothpick? Well, actually, let's start with the longer one. So the first one from the little edge there is going to be 3Z. Then next one's going to be 2Z. Two holes with the long toothpicks. I need part number 420. And 405. 420 is right here. Right above the middle, to the right of the center. And then 405 is a top left, right below the other 405 that we just pulled earlier. So with the number facing towards the assembly, we're doing through the bottom hole here. So we're just doing through the one long toothpick, and then the back hole is going to be on the short side. And now 405 is in the back here against 403, so I just need to push the toothpicks out the other way, just like that, against the surface, and then 405 with the little hook goes towards the top. Actually, let me put these two holes first, and then I'm gonna insert it on the onto the 3Z. Now we need another long toothpick going in the top hole of part number 420, and then part number 421, it's right here, no. Top, a little below the, or above the 405 that we just pulled, with a little mark towards the back, and around that surface, on the bottom, towards the bottom, goes through the two toothpicks. They're sticking out in the front, and now part number 406. Put a little bit of a candle wax on the tabs. Just like that. now 457, 421, there's 421s. And 457 is to the right here. Two of them too. So 457 first. Then 421. Then 457 again. And then 421. For number 408 and 409, we already have it fell out. 408 goes in the back here, and one little toothpick that is sticking out, 3Z, and then 409 goes on the back of these two. With the opening facing down. Moving on to the page number 64, we need parts number 410 through 413. There. 410, 411, 412, and 413. Six and seven. Step two, we need part number 414. It's right here, right at the center line, a little bit above, halfway between the middle and the top. Use our helping tool. All right, let's see. Need to, I think I actually just swap them into that little bag, into the pile. Two Z's. Now let's redo. So, I need one. It's all balance. Just gonna put them aside. Just took a little break. That's why. I don't remember if I made these or not, but just in case. See, we need two Z's. Two 3Zs. And then we need minus 10. This is dull now, so I need to get a new one or change the blade. Alright, so let's see, we need one 3Z inserted into 413 there. Then two Z's in the two top holes where the two holes around the tab there. And that goes over the 3Z. Actually, let's do this. I'll take the 3Z out. I'll put that part on 414. And then I'll put the 3Z in there as far as it can go. And now we lock it up with 415. 415 is located right here, it's number 9. To top two toothpicks. With the chamfer going, the sharp angle going towards the bottom of the seat here, towards the middle. And then 422. And the 422 is right here, right at the center, right about the middle of the board. Once again, with 8 facing towards the inside, it goes over the 2 toothpick. One more 3Z goes into the hole here, into the far hole. Over the 2 toothpicks. That one stays intact all the way to the end until it snaps onto the base there, 406. So I'm gonna use my helping tool, just give me a little bit of leverage, just like that, so everything is nice and tight. And now we put 417 on. And 417 is at the little below middle on the right of the center line. So that one goes with the 3 toothpicks. We cut the top one off. To the bottom one, the little number 3, and then the little toothpick that is sticking out. Sticking out there. Now we need another long toothpick stick, put it into 417 tab hole. Then we take and put that sub assembly into the 3 holes. Oh, and we cut the bottom one. So I'm gonna take that one out, cut the bottom one first. Top one and slide it in the back of the first seat into to the corresponding three holes. All the way to the surface, just like that. Moving on to the page number 65, we cut the two short toothpicks. Careful, don't cut yourself. And then put parts number 4, board number 8, 423, 424, and 425. So 425, 423 is all the way on top here. It's a fragile piece, so cut those out. .423 is at the top. Then .424 is on the bottom right here. And 425 is on the opposite end. Just gonna cut it off right away while I'm on the back side. So 424 and 425. Step number 2, we put those on, and so number 11 goes on first, through the two toothpicks, the bottommost. .324 is next, it's number 12 on there, and then number 13, which is .325, is the last one. Just like this. And now 432 which is that short part that was next to 409 with the number 2 on them. That goes right in the back here, securing all these three together. Or four boards together. Push it as far as it can go, as far as you can push it. Part number 427, two half toothpicks. Part number 427, which is still on board number 8. It's all the way to the left, a little bit above the middle. And then with the 10 from facing away from you, from your side, you insert the two toothpicks. All the way to the surface. And now we need 428, 429. They're right in the middle here, 428, 429. 430 is, let's see where 430 is at. Right here next to 432. It says 13, and then 14 would be 431. And then you insert the 428 first. Make sure the shape matches and the numbers are facing number 10 now. Then 429. Then 430. And then 431. And then we cut the toothpicks off. That little cushion we inserted on the top shelf here, all the way to the next seat. As far as I can go, we're done with page number 65. Now let's see. Next one is page number 66, and we need part number 426, which is on top here. Long piece number 14. And then that one goes through all three toothpicks. All the way to the edge there. As far as they can go. Now there's two holes. We need four toothpicks cut down by 10 millimeters. One, two, three. And two we insert into the two holes on the bottom there. Let's see, probably not all the way through, but just up to the surface and inside there. Through the surface because there's a shaft going through the middle of the car. So we're done with step number two. Now we need three 2Zs. We put them into part number 434 and 435. So 434 is found 435. That's number 16. And 434 is right here, number 15. Right above the middle, to the right of the center line. sharp edge facing towards you, 16 with the number 16 going towards you, so the tap is away from you. We put the part number take 433. It's a bottom right here next to the spare wiper blades. And then we put one of the longer ones on the bottom through the bottom hole with the 15 facing down. So bottom right would be the long toothpick, and then 2Z is gonna go hole from the second hole from the back there all the way to the surface. And now we insert it onto the sub assembly. So the top hole goes through the toothpick there. Through the front. Tab that we just made with the number 434 facing, well, in my case down or towards the seat, we put that on through the one hole that was there, and with the tab facing towards the back, just like this. Now next step, number 5, we cut that top toothpick off here. Part number 442, which is number 19 right here, right above, or 16, the wiper spare wipers. That one goes through the top hole, and then this little toothpick, the 2Z that is sticking out, that goes in the back hole. Now we use that long toothpick and put it in the bottom hole that is opened up right now. Just like that. And moving on to the page number 67. Here we insert, first we insert that 407. That's the longer part at the top. With the mark facing towards the back, and it goes through the two toothpicks in the front, and then 406. We got them separated there, they're on board 8. And I'll put a little bit of wax on the tabs, so it goes in smoother and easier, hopefully. As far as they can go, flush to the surface. Step number 2, we need 456, two of them, and four top right here. And two 407s, top left. So 456 first, through the two toothpicks all the way to the end. Then 407 with the marks facing towards the back once again. You need to pull the toothpicks a little bit out to get that one in. Then 456 again. And then 407 to lock it all up with the mark facing towards the back. Now we need part number 436. 436 is the one right here, the right of the center, a little bit to the right, halfway between the midline. And that one with the tab going on the back, we put it onto the that one toothpick that is sticking out here. All the way to the next one. part number 409. There's two more left. Locking it from the back. The first two holes. Now we slice off the little toothpick that is sticking out there. Clean up any leftovers there. And then we do 437 through 440. So 437. Keep that 434 just to make sure I don't lose it. So 437 through 440. 437, 438, 439, and 440. So that would be 18, 19. Put a little wax on those. My fingers getting exhausted, so it's not as easy to put them in anymore. That's 440. And now we need 3Z and two 2Zs. Well, three 2Zs. Kind of skipped that part in the beginning. So we need three 2Zs. One. Two and three, and then 1 3Z. So the 2Zs, 3Z goes into that hole that we just inserted on 440. As far as I can go. And then 2Zs go into part number 441. 403. 441 is the last one here in that sequence. It goes into the top hole with the tap facing away from you and the little rounded up surface towards the top. And the middle hole. Now 403, and that's two of them here. With a sharp point down towards you. Just like that. And now that goes into that little tab right here and toothpick. And then the last piece is number 443, all the way to the right, right above the middle. 443, 2Z's inserted through the last hole where that sharp point is, or thinner point portion is, so the hole right next to it, into there, and then it goes through the two toothpicks and two little tabs on a 406. Once again, as far as they can go. number 68. We'll close it up. Actually, let's do two Z's and three Z's. Two Z's, two Z's. One and two. And two three Z's. Part number 402. That would be longer piece that I had on board number 8, which is right here. So that goes three of these. We cut down the bottom one. Bottom toothpick and two small toothpicks that are sticking out. They all match up. And then after we put that on, we put number 433. Wipers, and that one get a 3Z in the back here, in the back hole. As far as I can go. Gets the on that sharp point, gets a 3Z from this side also, and then we do one toothpick and that 3Z that we just put in into the, and the one toothpick goes through the top holder. Step number 3, we cut off that first toothpick. And then we also put two Z's into 434, which is number 15 right here, and then 435. 16. So these 15 gets to 2Z's. And then 16 with the tab facing down, 16 facing 15, through the two top toothpicks, top two holes. Together, and then that goes through the top toothpick in the back as far as it can go. We're done with step number 3. Moving on to step number 4, we need one toothpick without, with 10 millimeters cut off. That one goes into the hole on part number 433 that we just installed in the top, in the bottom hole, and then 444 goes over it. 444 is number 16 right here, a little bit to the right of the center line, a little bit above the middle. And then with 16 facing down, let's see, the bottom hole And then this little toothpick that is sticking out, a number 433. Those are get joined together, just like this. Now step number five, I guess we need another toothpick, which is set for, so I guess we need two of these. That toothpick goes into the top hole of part that we just put in, 444, and then we need 421. I have one laying around already with the little mark facing towards the back of that seat sub-assembly. And move that all the way down. Now we need another part number 406. Once again, I have it sitting around because it fell off. And that goes into the two holes. Back seat. We're done with step number six, moving on to page number 69. Now we need parts number 421, two of them, and 457, two of them. 421's right here. And I want to say those are 467 rather than 457. I don't see 457s. Mark it up. Or they're marked wrong on the board. One or the other. So 457 first, then 421, then 457 again, or 467, whatever number it is, and then 421 again. Next, we're on step number two, and part number 409. Once again, I have that one sitting out too. So that one gets inserted, or actually let's do number one. 436 is first, it's step number one. So let's see, 436, that's number 17. That puts on, gets put on first onto that little toothpick in the back, and then 409 joins them together. Next are parts number 437 through 440. Sound just fell out, and that's what I was looking for. 438, 439, and 440. 18. Careful with the toothpicks, they're still there. 19, 20, and then 21. I'll go together. it's 440. And then we need three twosies. Now we need part number 441, just the end of that cluster on the top, and then on the bottom of it we put a 3Z, which is not marked. Just a little to the right of the center, right above the middle there. Goes on the bottom, and then the two toothpicks through the. Actually, let's do 2Z first through that back hole. Through the two toothpicks in the front of the back seat and onto the tabs of the seat cushion. Next step is part number 403, which is right in the center there, or to the right of the center line, and that one gets two 2Zs into the holes, but I'm gonna put them into the part that is already installed on 441. Using the tool to push those toothpicks in, and then 403 with the sharp point facing towards you and bottom. Just insert that over, and then 419, we cut off the top toothpick there. Up and 419 in the bottom right here, that goes with the three four toothpicks that are there, two sticking out, and then two little short ones in the back there. That, and then we cut off all these sharp toothpicks that are there. Moving on to the page number 70, and we got nice flooring there. Let's see, we tap out the middle portion, and then that gets inserted in step one, inserted underneath the drive shaft there. then step number two, insert the seats, and there is four holes. I would wax them. Go. Let's see, those go with the long part towards the front. Right in the center there. I need to open the doors a little bit. Sit them in nice and tight. And the next part is 446. They're right in the middle here of board number 8. Step number 3. Now we open the doors. There's two holes in there, so these get inserted. Gonna put a little bit of a wax on those two. So there's kind of like a straight part and angular part, so the straight or a sharp angle that goes towards the seat. Fully seated. Carpeting shifted slightly. I'll need probably to take the piece, short piece out. To insert that part in. We're done with step number 3 on board on page number 70. Now little details. Step number 1 on 71. You need part number 450 on the bottom left there. That's all the tooling. And then 448 right above that. Now we need 6 twosies. Did I lose it? Nope. Still here. And the last one, number 6. Now we need 3 of them go through number 448. 450. Goes right onto those toothpicks. Now 451. There's two of them. Inserted into the these two bottom holes from the side of the part 450. I lost my helping tool there. I'm just pushing it all the way through so they're flush with the 450. We got that part, and then step number three, we need 449 and 447. So 447 says tools on it. 449 got more tools. And then the other three toothpicks go into these holes. Still recording, which is good. Then we put a 449 on top of it. So tools, let's see, facing upside down, hammers towards right. But in reality, I don't think it would matter which way you put it in. And then two more 451s. Go from inside also, from the side of 449, and then push them in until they're flush. We got that. Now number five, we cut the toothpick in half. And then that those go, we combine these two, and they go from one side or the other, going through the hole. Sub-assemblies. And then you cut it off on the other side, flush. Now you got yourself a little nice toolbox. Page number 72, sorry. Now we put that one aside. Let's see, part number 74, we're still on board number 8, two 74s, they were to the right here, then 261 and 262 to bottom left, whatever the parts are left, and 261 is to the right of the wiper blades. Now I would wax 261. A little bit of ascending and waxing. And 262, and then waxing on the outside. Off 74. So 74. Goes on first, then 262 from the back all the way through. 74, and then another 74 on there to light that gear up. Now we need part number 452 and 459. Oops. So 452 is to the left there, and then 459 is that little cross. Goes through that hole here. Let's see, with a little tab sticking up, and the longer part of 462 goes through, and then we put that cross attached right to it, just like that. Now we need two 453s. There are two parts right here, right at the center, to the right a little bit of the center. Go from the side of the gear and the bottom two holes. Now we need 4Z, two of them. Second 452. 458 will need the tool help me out. 452 and 455. They all together in that little cluster. So let's see. These two holes. So two holes here. The further one, like on the tab, that's the one that goes through 452, and the second one goes outside of it, so tab away from you, just like this. And then 455, we got the little hook there for the rubber band, so that one's closer to the right hand side, and then you insert the two toothpicks in corresponding little holes. And the toothpick should stick out on the other side of 455. Now we do step number 5, we need 454. That's a little part with the teeth here, with the tab facing away from you. I would wax the teeth. Inside of that slot. So now with the hook facing away from you, let's see, the slots go right here. And they match with the gear, and then we attach 452 part, those little tabs. Now the toothpicks, they go through too. did, and now we need about 24 millimeter rubber band. And I already forget how to make a loop. Four millimeters, cut it off, and then that goes let's see, through the site where there is the little cross. So we insert it into the little hook there, and the knot is going to be in between right here. That's the exclamation point. That's step number 7. Then we wrap it around through the top two hooks. Around the toothpick here, and then around it here, and then on the bottom. On the opposite end, I just make sure it hooks there. And then I'm gonna use the, let's see if I'm gonna find it, little paper clip that we had here. I'm gonna use that paper clip to pull out that excess of the rubber band, just like this. And let's see, now we need part number 460. I was wondering what it is for. That's the one with the tabs going on inside. And then that goes, let's see, with all the sub-assembly facing the direction of that long hole that gets inserted into the that part number 460. And we got ourselves a little jack. Up. Alright, so I'm gonna put that aside too. Now we need 3Z. Plenty of toothpicks here. Just make sure it's not the broken portion. One 3Z, and then one rubber band, two rubber bands that are about 33 millimeters long. And then two. Let's see, now we turn the car upside down and we insert. insert. There's a little hole right here, so that's where the 3Z is gonna go into. The 3Z all the way to the back so just a little bit sticks out, and then use one of the rubber bands that we just did. That goes a little hook right there. See if we can feed it in there somehow. Definitely not with your fingers. Not sure how. So I'm gonna use my precision file tool, or try to use it, to try to get it in there. Sure not to break anything, because there's a high chance of that happening if you squeeze too much. Oh, I think I can open the trunk and actually feed the rubber band through there. Side so I can hook it. Maybe one side and the other side, so it's hooked on there, and then we hang it face down, I guess. Onto that. It up with the rubber band. Now on the other side we need the second rubber band for step number 3 for the toolbox. Now first we need to hook that rubber band through the little hole on the bottom right there, since my car is upside down, so it's going to be driver's side. Somehow the rubber band through that little hole, in which case I'm gonna use my little paper clip. The rubber band, push it out, and then feed it onto the each end onto the hooks. Don't pull out. There we go. It's now locked in there, hopefully. Yep, it's gonna stay in there. And I'm gonna take that rubber band, take the toolbox. Where's it at? Put it upside down on there, and now hook the rubber band around the top hooks there. Just like that. Everything is good. And the toolbox is now sitting in the bottom there too. Now let's see, this part is fine. We're all good. Heard a little cracking sound, wasn't sure what it is, but seems like didn't break anything, it was just starting. Now part number, page number 74. We're done with the assembly. So now, let's see, we'll move that away to the right, and we press to open the trunk, and then we do about 15 rotations. 1, 2, 3. To note, 15 half rotations, not full rotation, so it's only 7.5 technically if you do 360. But it's 15, 180. So I'm at 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Now we move it forward, is all the way to the right. To the back, and then when we snap on that, it's in neutral and just fires away. Yep. Now try it again. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Lock the car. Let's see. So now when I switch the gear, need to make sure that it engages right here in the back. So it's engaged, it should be in forward, and it drives away. And the wheels move, so we're good to go. That portion, and then reverse, you should go down and check in the back, make sure it's disengaged, and bottom gears engage. So here's the top gear, and then you move the other way, make sure disengage and engage the bottom gears there. Then you can move forward and back. So once you play with it a little bit, it should work. Now we also do little wipers here. And then now let's see, now we, I already tested the lift there, the jack. So that one was already tested. And we're done. Guess this is the car. Now the windows roll up, obviously, zero number. The back windows. But how do you reach them to get them rolled up? That's a good question. So you pull the seats back, and there's a little roller there. Start it up and just lift it up there. So that's with the windows. And you can move the seats up and down. Steering wheel works. There's obviously a little engine compartment, so there's a to open it up, and all the pistons also move once you wind it up. So we're all good to go. Everything is done. The assembly is complete. Once again, my name is Dimitri. I'm with Ugears US. My company name is Ugears LLC, so I'm doing business as Ugears US. My website is www.ugearsus. All the models are available on there. Most of the time they're in stock and ready to ship within a short amount of time. If you need any part replacement, once again, you can find the information there. Videos for other models are available. If you have any questions, just leave comments below of the video, or send me email at info@ugears.us. Thank you for watching. See you guys later. Bye.